There's nothing like getting a package in the mail, and I got one from my buddy Eric K, who's a subscriber of the channel and who actually offered to go ahead and get me a couple of the Wyze Sense here. So he sent me these. So again, thank you, Eric. So what I'm going to do today is I'm just going to get these opened up and set them up with my Wyze Cam here. I think I want to use them in the garage ultimately, but we're going to talk about a few different topics here with the Wyze Sense. Now, everyone's been blown away by just how small these boxes are, and for $20, you know, I don't know what we were expecting, but this is impressive stuff. So the first thing you're taking out of the box, yeah, here it is. It's a little Wyze connector, basically. So this is called the Wyze Bridge, and it does plug into the back of your Wyze Cam. So now I've opened everything up, and just to give you a frame of reference, I've brought out a Google Home Mini, and I think you can see the differential in size here, okay? And a more applicable measurement would be this Samsung SmartThings V3. So you can see it's about, I don't know, about half the size overall in terms of maybe square inches here. But ultimately, these are extremely small devices coming out of the box. That's what everyone's been surprised by. Even myself, as I got into it here, it's surprising. One other funny little touch that they did here, I just wanted to tell you about. There is some stickers actually that Wyze has provided you to stick on the different components. I won't be doing that, but it is kind of interesting. Now, in terms of a setup, what you have to be making sure you've done is you've gotten the app updated, and you also need the firmware updated on these products. So we'll head into the Wyze application, get set up here, and start our setup process. So here we are, and if you get a requirement or a request to go and upgrade the firmware on your devices, make sure you do that. You do need the latest firmware here from Wyze in order to get these all working. Now, what they tell you to do is add a product, but what they also want you to do is stick this into the back of your Wyze Cam. So what I'm going to show you here is this is going into the slot here. So you heard it click, and now I'm supposed to wait for the ready light to basically come back blue. So just so I can show you, you can see both lights here on the back are a solid blue. So inside the application now, I'm just simply going to hit up in the top right, we're going to hit add a product, and we're going to add the different components one at a time here. We've also been given this little piece here, so I'll show you that up close, and this is basically going to plug in to the different components as you go through the setup process, but I'll show you as we go through that. Now, the Wyze contact sensor is the first thing I'm going to add here. So now I need to choose which device I'm going to add it to. The House One camera is the only one that I have the bridge in, so that's what we're adding it to. I get a little notification here, and what they're telling me is insert this and press the reset button until the red light flashes 3 times. Okay, so I'm going through this as you guys normally would, but we're going to do this, and that's a reset button, and we should see it start to flash red. There you go. It's now flashed 3 times. So there you go. That was extremely quick for a connection process, extremely easy. Now we have to name the device, which name it whatever you want. With these being so small, I can see them being useful in many different spaces than some of the larger contact sensors. What I will tell you is that I did receive one of these with the back already removed, so you might need to replace the 3M sticky tape here. I don't know if that's really possible on device itself, but we'll go ahead and we'll just name this one Test One. So now you're seeing Test One in the application. It's already there. We're good to go. We can go ahead and add these other products, and I'm just going to add them relatively quickly. So the motion sensor, again, House One, and it is the same exact process here. You're just simply pressing into here, and there you go. There's the sensor flashing. Once it flashes 3 times, it's basically going through the next setup process. Again, we have to name it. I'm just gonna call this Motion 1. I have really complex and fancy names. So now in terms of a setup process, I'm gonna stop there. I have the two devices in here. I actually named it Motion Q and Test 1. And it's reading motion right now, although I don't know exactly why it's reading that motion. But I am noticing that as I move these sensors apart, I am getting the notification that it's moved to open and then back to close. So we do have what seems to be working sensors. So let's do a couple of tests here just to see the distance that we're getting for this sensor. So I would say that's the distance right there. You can see it on screen right now, but that's the distance that, you know, I put that about an inch to an inch and a half. That's actually quite far apart for you to maintain in order to have an open status there. So now that we have both of these devices set up, let's quickly go through the changes in your application. You will see the two new, or three new, if you set up the third one, devices there inside of your application. Now, the contact sensor, you can review the history, and what's interesting is if you set triggers or triggers of this when it opens to actually have it record something, you will see the recording directly and you can go into that recording. So that's very nice functionality right there. Now on top of that, you can also see the status, but there is a settings component up at the top. You can go ahead and change the name, and here's where you can trigger notifications. Now those notifications opens, closed, or is left open with the contact sensor. Basically it's motion or cleared with the motion sensor, which I'll show you in a minute. But then you also want to know whether you or not you're going to trigger sensor videos. And you could see I've triggered sensor videos on one of my cameras, not both of them, but you could do both of them if you'd like, and it doesn't have to have a bridge in it. You only need one to have a bridge, and then you can trigger multiple cameras if you'd like to start recording. There is a little bit of device info here, and you can see the battery, and there's a little latch on the side of these devices to open up, get to the battery. There was a 2450 here in the motion sensor, and you can also see the signal strength, and there's a MAC address that is the address for the RF system between these two, so you can see that as well. And like I said, the motion sensor, very similar. You can go into there, see when motion was detected, when it wasn't, when it's cleared, and you can set the same notifications, just become, you see motion, it becomes clear, or you have the video sensor setting. So do you want to trigger a video off of this actually detecting motion? You can go ahead and do that. And then again, in your history, as you're reviewing those, you will see that. So let's get into what I think about these devices so far. The devices themselves, I mean, that really small component and the ability to trigger events off of these and have recordings go straight to the cloud or straight to a local recording on that device, very, very powerful functionality. And I mean, ultimately, $20 Wyze Cam version 2 and a $20 pack here, starter kit from Wyze that allows you to do all of these things. The sensors themselves feel very strong. They don't feel like there's any concern here. At least I don't have any concern right out of the box. The fact that they are so small makes, especially the contact sensor here, very nondescript, and it's going to stay out of the way in a lot of locations in your home. So that's very nice. This motion sensor being that black color, if you don't have something to kind of camouflage that, well, I could see this standing out a little more. Maybe it's a little less nondescript, but it is so small that still you could put this in a lot of places. The other thing that's really important about this is these have instantly been integrated into If This Then That. And that is obviously going to make this very powerful. You're now able to trigger a lot of different things. And for myself, as I think about my Samsung SmartThings system, well, now I can trigger events within there. I can trigger different events in all kinds of systems. But anytime this opens or closes, And anytime this detects motion or becomes clear, I can trigger an applet to start working right then and there. So that makes these extremely powerful externally, not just through the Wyze system. The Achilles heel of the whole system is twofold, actually, at this point. Number one, your RF network has to be okay, and you can interrupt these signals. I will say that as they've been sitting together, I have seen a little bit of lag already inside the application, and I will say that I think the camera is starting to hit its end in terms of processing power. I have it continuously recording, and I have it now with a bridge on it. So I'm trying to push the limits, and I would say we're getting close to the limits on the Wyze Cam version 2 here, and we may in the future see a Wyze Cam version 3 have to come out that integrates with all this equipment, because I do think they're nearing the end here. You can go see a new video that we have that talks about the three configurations for just your Wyze Cams that really helps you set this up. And when you start to pair these devices with that, your configurations can get more complex, but they also don't have to. And I like that approach by Wyze. This can be added to the system and just simply trigger your cameras, and it really doesn't have to change anything else within your configuration. But you can go watch that video. It's up on screen now. Otherwise, guys, we'll see you next time.